coming up on this week's news. The IET unveils a guide for electricians installing battery packs to clarify installation procedures. A judge fines a cosmetics company over the risk of electrocution at its factory, and fuse links are being recalled over safety fears. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to access their online store. Whether you're listening in the van, on site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The IET has unveiled a special guide for electricians installing home battery systems to clarify the installation procedures. The move follows rising demand for the systems, coupled with widespread uncertainty in the trade about best practices. The publication of a fast-tracked standard in March attempted to address some of the trade's concerns, especially over the location options for battery packs. This new 100-page guide sets out to answer the questions installers are increasingly asking themselves. It complements, but doesn't replace, BS7671, which the IET also writes. And it's much more specific than the regs. For instance, while BS7671 states that your local DNO needs to be informed of a connection, the IET's guide lists the 7 specific ways that electricians should do this, depending on the install. The document advises on the points of isolation called up by the wiring regs and sets out the warning notices that need to be added to a job to remain compliant. It restates the requirement that the current rating of the switchgear be greater or equal to the sum of the rated currents of both the incoming isolator and the output of all forms of generation on the property. It also shows the 3 designs you can use to achieve this. The IET says that type AC RCD should not be used in properties with renewables, especially if the installation has island mode capability. This is because there may be DC or high frequency components from inverter generated supplies in currents that flow in resistive loads. The organisation says that circuits connecting generators should, as far as practicable, be designed so that RCDs are not necessary. Where RCDs must be used, they should be for bidirectional operation. Disconnect all the live conductors, including the neutral, and be installed in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions. There's also advice on earthing, cable sizing, and earth loop impedances. This guide is out for public consultation until Monday, the 4th of November 2024. You can download the document and comment to help improve it by clicking the link in the show notes. In other news, a cosmetics and beauty firm has been fined after inspectors found its premises posed serious risks of both electric shock and electrocution. The health and safety executive carried out an unannounced inspection at Sable Cosmetics Limited on Pelham Lane, Halifax, in July 2022. The case has only come to court this month. Inspectors found employees were at risk of coming into contact with exposed live parts on equipment and machinery. They said there was a systematic failure within the company to address the highlighted dangers. At Leeds Magistrates Court last week, the company admitted health and safety breaches and was slapped with a fine of £56,000 and ordered to pay £6,000 in costs. After the hearing, Inspector Andrea Jones told the BBC that it was essential that electrical wiring installations and equipment are built and maintained in a safe condition to prevent injuries or death. She says that in this case, simple, inexpensive steps could have been taken to remedy the most serious defects. Instead, the company's inaction has resulted in more than £60,000 in fines and costs. Sable, which manufactures hair and body products, has yet to comment on the case. Still in the courts, an inquest has been hearing how a teenager from Folkestone in Kent was electrocuted at a railway station. 18-year-old Tom Watson came into contact with a live line at Canterbury East Station and was later struck by a train. A full hearing to examine the circumstances of his death is yet to take place, but his family has previously said there is clear evidence he had no intent to take his own life. The popular teenager had been out with friends the previous night and was due to start an English degree at the University of Lincoln just days later. The inquest was adjourned for a pre-inquest review to take place on the 7th of November. The South Coast's boat builders have got together to put out a plea for electricians with sea legs like a catfish. The thriving marine industry around the Solent is trying to address a skills shortage for sparks. Companies such as Sunseeker, Oyster Yachts and White Shipyard desperately need people to wire up their vessels. Now their representative body, Solent Partners, has unveiled free training to convert standard electricians into marine specialists. People taking part in the special 12-week course will learn essential marine electrical systems and procedures. At the end, they'll gain the certification needed to take on critical roles in the sector. The Marine Electrician Skills Bootcamp will be delivered by British Maritime Training and Assessment. The course involves a combination of face-to-face and online learning, and on completion, guarantees an interview with local employers. I popped a link to the opportunity in the show notes. And speaking of free training, our latest question of the week was taken from our CPD module on continuity testing made in association with TIS. In it, Joe Hammond takes you through this critical first dead test from your very first attempts at college through AM2 practice and right up to on-site work. So wherever you are in your electrical journey, there's something in there for you. The question was, when carrying out a continuity test of a new installation, which points should we carry out the test from? The correct answer is, test at every point of the installation that has a CPC. And despite some complaints from people who thought the question was poorly worded, 83% of people got it right on YouTube, while over on LinkedIn, where most of the complaints came from, a very respectable 79% got it. We've also started to post our question of the week on X, it still pains me to call it that, where 64% of people were correct. We've temporarily removed biscuit privileges from the pesky editor who made the question allegedly ambiguous until he's learned his lesson. In product news this week, German manufacturer Siba is recalling a batch of its fuse links over safety fears. The issue over the fuses was flagged up by UK trading standards. The metal links, size NH000, were available to purchase from April to July this year. The product has been identified by the company as presenting a risk because the sand sealing cap may not seal correctly, and this could cause the sand to leak during use in high vibration environments. This can in turn negatively influence the extinguishing behaviour of the fuse in the event of a short circuit. In short, the product is not compliant. Electricians should tell their customers to stop using the product. They should also contact the customer service team to arrange for it to be returned. I've put a link to the document with the specification and manufacturer's dates and the company contacts. Meanwhile, Scolmore has settled its long-running row with Dean Electrical Wholesale, Premspec Group and Dennis Bosley, the founder of Dean Electrical and Premspec. The dispute arose after Scolmore found out that Dean had been selling counterfeit double sockets in the UK. It was mixing them up with and selling them alongside genuine Scolmore products. The counterfeits had been bought in China by Premspec under Bosley's instructions. Scolmore says it took a stand because it wanted to urgently get the products off the market. In a statement published on its website, Dean says that it, Premspec and Bosley accept that the import of the sockets amounted to trademark infringement, which they regret, and for which they have paid compensation to Scolmore. The defendants have also paid substantial damages and costs and given strict undertakings to Scolmore. Scolmore boss Kevin Beach told eFIXX that it was shocking that some people were happy to go to China and think they have found a bargain alternative to a genuine Scolmore product supplied by a factory which is nothing to do with Scolmore and which is unable to provide any certification or proof of origin. He emphasised that these are mains voltage products and that the defendants took no steps to even make sure they were safe before selling them on to unsuspecting buyers. Beach warned that Scolmore wouldn't hesitate to take more legal action in the future to protect its brand. A unique spray which acts like a pair of galoshes and blacks out solar panels to prevent them from generating electricity has been shortlisted for an award. PV Stop, which comes in a black metal bottle like a fire extinguisher, is in line for recognition from Electrical Safety First. The product was invented for a simple reason. You can't turn off a PV panel. As long as there's light, they'll produce lethal amounts of DC power. PV Stop works like liquid tarpaulin, says Jacktone, the firm who created it. When you spray it on a panel, it will spread over it rapidly and black it out. In effect, it turns the panel off. PV Stop is effective on all types of solar PV systems and all types of inverters. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects, and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. In October, we're focusing on heating and ventilation and commercial solar and battery. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry, it's SunSync. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home, its environment. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. And with an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear to a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart, it's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all, we really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words I've smuggled into today's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were Jedi and Hobbit, which I'm pretty sure a Jedi-Hobbit is the crossover all science fiction and fantasy fans have been waiting for. And the winner we plucked from our digital hat was Amy Tiger. So well done to you. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click that link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there. And remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.